famous broadcast center known as the Chum City Building, home of much music and the site tonight of yet still another cool, intimate, and interactive. Tonight featuring Silverchair.
Now, Phil is going to be inside with the band in a nice, intimate setting, but I'll be out here with all of these fans, and we will be taking your questions.
I think it's very cool that Silverchair are here tonight, because did you know today marks the worldwide release of Freak Show today, and they're here in Canada. And also, I don't know if you know this or not, but Canada is the very best market internationally for Silverchair. Very cool.
Excellent, and that's no surprise. As you can see, all of these people have been here from the wee hours of the morning. We'll be taking your questions via fax, phone, and email. So write down the numbers that you see on your screen right now. Get your questions in early, because as you can see, you're in competition with all of these guys.
I'm ready. I know you're ready. Kathleen, are you ready?
I'm ready. Are you guys ready?
Okay, here they are. Silverchair!
Thank you. Yeah, rock on. For this song, we've got another guitarist. He's not going to stand on the stage because he's a bit embarrassed. He's going to stand over there, so if you can see him, you give him a round of applause. Ready? New album called Freak Show, and it's called Cemetery. I'm going to do it by myself.
Cemetery, don't forget to say. Anyway.
Thanks. It's good to see people standing up. Thanks. This is our next single. We'll be right back.
Oh, yeah! Very loud. What? What? Very loud. Very good and loud. Well done. Very cool. You know what? There's still a whole lot more playing from Silverchair coming up, and also a lot of talking, and that's where you're involved. If you have maybe a phone call or a fax or email, here's how to get in touch with Silverchair tonight.
If you would like to get intimate and interactive with Silverchair, for questions and comments, the toll-free number to call is 1-800-265-MUCH. That's 1-800-265-6824. By fax, the number to call is area code 416-591-MUCH. That's area code 416-591-6824. You can also communicate by email. The address is silver@muchmusic.com.
Does everybody get that? We want to hear from you, so please get dialing. Coming up, some more Silverchair, but first, an ever-so-short break. So please, hang on. Yeah, what'd you think? Nice and... Yeah. Back with Silverchair. They are intimate and they are interactive here tonight at Much Music. It's like the first set. There's still a whole lot more music coming. I liked it. It was very good. You know what I'm expecting, though? You know what I'm expecting? I think a herd of wild elephants with bearded ladies to come walking through any second, because our set design looks a lot like Freak Show, the album cover and the whole concept of the album. Can I ask you why you called it Freak Show? Daniel?
We called it Freak Show because we saw similarities between a traveling rock band and the old traveling freak shows, just because of how they travel around from town to town, and all the people out there think the people in bands are really different people, but they're not, and that's the same with the freaks, so that's pretty much it.
Very good. I think Frog Stomp went on to sell something like 3 million copies. And I know that you've said you like Freak Show as an album much better than Frog Stomp. How come?
Thanks, Daniel. I think we played better on Freak Show. And I think the songs, because we're older when we wrote them, like, I think they were just better songs. Because we wrote like the songs on Frog Stomp when we were like 12, 13 or something. So we were kind of sick of them by the time we recorded them. Yeah, so they're just all like, you know, fresh songs, so they're more fun to play.
Chris did that. I don't know what you did, but I'm going to be blaming you.
You are. That was that little potty trick.
Good one, John, you.
Thank you. Okay, I've done my share, and I have some more stuff to ask you a little bit later, but a lot of people here have questions to ask. We're going to start off with this guy, actually. What is your name?
Chuck. I was wondering, like, when you take bands like Rush or Primus or Blackwater, Vertical Smile, and I was just thinking if, like, a three-piece band was what you guys originally wanted, and if it has its advantages when you're, like, touring and stuff.
It has advantages and disadvantages. It's a lot easier touring-wise, because when you get in an argument, like we often do, you're just outnumbered all the time, 2-1, Ben and Chris versus Daniel. But when you got a 4 or 5 piece, it's much easier to get a thicker sound, and you can produce what you recorded on the album a lot easier, just because on most 3-piece albums there's at least 2 guitar tracks. But we don't care, keep it simple, and yeah, simple's best, said Chris.
You are a traveling band, as you said earlier, but you know, maybe there'd be a little bit of fighting here and there, but you're all still very good friends. That's first and foremost, right?
Yes.
Brothers, friends?
Yes.
Good. Okay. You know what? We have a traveling speakers corner unit right across Canada, and I think we're going to take a look at a question. This is coming from Montreal. If I can direct you to a monitor over there.
Let me show you something.
Listen carefully.
Hi, my name is Dan. I work at HMV in Montreal. I have a question for Silverchair. I was wondering why you chose the song Tomorrow to be entered in the competition in Australia for the radio station, and why you chose to enter the competition in the first place.
Go ahead, Chris. Do you want to handle it?
I think Tomorrow is probably one of our better songs, and
I think they think so too.
We kind of entered the competition because we kind of just sort of did as much stuff as we could to get noticed and heard by everybody as possible, and that's my little trick again. And it kind of just worked.
And is it true that I read that you're maybe sick of Tomorrow a little bit, Daniel?
Yes.
Are you?
No, it's, we don't mind playing it, it's just we've been playing it since we were about 13 or 14, so after 4 or 5 years it gets a little boring. But it's all right.
You're still very proud of it.
Think of Aerosmith, though.
Aerosmith.
They've been playing some of their songs for like 15 years or something. They'd be kind of sick of them.
Looks like a lady.
That's true. He does. Okay, you know what? I think we have a phone call right now. Is our caller there? Who are you and where are you calling from? Oh, this is Derek from North Bay, I believe. Derek, are you on the line?
Yes, I'm on the line. I just want to say to you guys, this is the first time I've heard you live, and you sound spectacular.
I can't hear Derek. Derek, can you speak up a little bit?
This is the first time I've heard you guys live, and you sound spectacular. And I'm just wondering what your musical educational background is, like if you taught yourself or if you had lessons or whatnot.
Chris?
Well, we kind of just sort of started out. We had, you know, we'd have a lesson, and someone would teach us a cover song of someone else. So that was pretty much the lesson of the week. Yeah. And basically, we'd just learn everything else by just sort of messing around and being idiots.
Okay. And I got to say, your album's going to go number one. I can guarantee you guys that.
Thank you.
Thanks a lot.
A lot of people here wishing for that, and I'm sure it'll happen too. But I guess at school, it was like folk songs in terms of music at school, wasn't it?
Pretty much, my lessons were just, when I first started figuring out Black Sabbath and Zeppelin songs, and then I saw a Deep Purple video, and Richie Blackmore said that he had classical lessons for a year, so I decided to copy him, and I did that, and I hated it, so I stopped.
Okay, you know what? We're on the web, and a lot of people are emailing some questions. And if you can look at a monitor, I think we're going to have an email question right now. Okay, it says, hey, I have heard some cuts off the new album, and I'm hearing you guys use different instruments, like the timpanis and violins and stuff like that. I want to know what brought about this change in your songwriting.
I think those sort of instruments were used just because the song kind of really suited it, and we kind of liked those kind of sounds that Led Zeppelin were getting with the Led Zeppelin number 3 record, and just all the old acoustic violins and timpani, as you said, just sound really good for those songs.
This some people are calling it your third record, I guess, for that. Would you agree? It's almost like you skipped any kind of sophomore record and went right to an experimenting kind of stage.
We experimented a lot more because on the first album we were a lot younger and we didn't have any recording experience, so we just decided to put down a really rough sounding, raw, live kind of feeling album. And that gave us more room to kind of experiment on this album and use different stuff, just because we showed people that we could play.
Well, I know that on Cemetery there's a string section, and when you do it live, you've altered it a bit. I guess some of the songs that have those elaborate arrangements are altered live.
Yeah, it's always good for a live, when you see a band live, the songs to sound different. Otherwise, we can just stick 3 cardboard cutouts and chuck the CD on.
Very good. Kathleen is outside, and she has someone, I'm sure she's very wet, and she has someone who also has a question. Kathleen, are you out there? Are you keeping warm?
I'm out here, Bill, actually, yes. Here we are with some many, many wet Silverchair fans, but they're having a good time, nonetheless. Secondly, I have Margosha here, and she has a question for Silverchair. What's your question?
My question is, how did it feel from being normal kids, leading a normal life, to becoming rock stars and famous?
Did you get that question, Bill?
Yeah, I think... Daniel, do you want to tackle that? Because I know the band hates the whole rock star thing.
Can the people out there hear us at all?
Yep.
Yeah? All right. We're not into the whole rock star crap thing that a lot of bands seem to get tied up in. We're just people and playing a rock band and then go home and eat food.
Well, Ben, can I ask you, what do you think is a rock star kind of thing?
Is
it an attitude? Is it maybe things that...
Teased hair.
I'm sorry?
Teased hair. that's my opinion of a rock star.
Okay.
Yeah, I can't
Poison
add any
night
more to
rack.
It, I'm sorry.
Okay, you know what? There's still a whole lot more talking from Silverchair, and also some playing. But you got to hang on because we'll be right back. Please don't go away. Definitely here at Mott's. They are intimate and they are interactive. If you just joined us, you missed a whole batch of really good music. Still some more music to come. But you know what, guys? We have another one of those traveling speakers corner units. And check it out.
Hi, I'm Brandon Thiessen. I'm standing here in front of the beautiful library here in Vancouver, BC. And I have a question for Silverchair. This one's directed particularly at Daniel. I heard there was a little incident on the beach with some of the Chili Peppers. There's some jail thing going on. Think you can tell me anything about that?
Daniel? What's the scoop there?
We were test driving a car for this magazine, and we were supposed to just drive it in the car park, but it was boring, so we saw the beach and it looked inviting, so we drove on it and got in trouble.
No, it's with Dave Navarro.
Yes.
Was there a day in jail? I heard
no.
A couple. No.
I just went there and these policemen looked at me and made me scared. And then I
You could handle anything, I think. I think we have Matt on the phone. Matt, are you there, bud?
Hi.
Hi, Matt.
How's
What's your question, and who's it for?
It's for anyone. It doesn't really matter. I was just wondering if the band could tour with anyone, who would it be?
How about you, Chris? You want to handle that?
If we toured with Korn, they'd probably make us look bad. So probably someone old, like... Be good to go on a tour with the real Led Zeppelin or something like that, if they could be alive.
Oh, cool, all right. Thanks a lot.
Yeah, we would go on tour with TLC.
But with the Spice Girls, maybe? No, we're not talking about Spice Girls.
They're not really... Oh, yeah, actually, they're cool, yeah.
Okay. And who has a question here? I think you do.
Okay.
What's your name?
Suzanne. I just want to know what you do for fun, like in your spare time.
Any spare time?
Sleep.
We sometimes just sort of...
I surf.
You've got to talk into the mic, Chris.
I go to the beach.
I'm scared it's going to do my trick.
Thank you very much. Go, Chris. Yeah, go.
There's a lot of beaches around home, so we kind of spend a lot of time at the beach and surfing and stuff like that.
I think we're all in agreement there. You all love the beach.
I love my dog.
Ben, you? Beach as well?
Yeah, beach.
Okay. This is a fax that came in from Melissa in Montreal, Quebec, and she wants to know, she has read almost everything, interview and articles she can on you guys. There's a whole lot of gushing in here, so let's just get to the point. What is Daniel's opinion on all of the comparisons that are being made between him and that K word, I guess, Kurt?
I don't know. I don't care.
It's kind of almost old now, too, isn't it?
It's kind of stupid, but doesn't bother me.
Okay.
Be honest.
I've got blonde hair, you know.
Be honest, Daniel.
Yeah, it worries me a lot.
Somehow I think you're lying there. But anyway, we're going to go outside once again. We have Kathleen standing by at the Speaker's Corner booth attached to the building. And Kathleen, are you keeping dry at least?
Yes, we're out here, Bill, outside of the Chum City building. And as you know, it is home to the original Speaker's Corner. And speaking of which, we have Nick and his dad who have a question for Silverchair. You guys ready? Go ahead, ask your question.
Yeah, Daniel and Ben and Chris, I was just wondering, I heard you usually tour with your parents, and I was just wondering if that cramps your style.
Doesn't really.
We don't have style to cramp.
It's all right. We kind of, hello. They just sort of hang around. They don't really annoy us that much. I mean, they don't do that much with us. They're normally off doing something else. They just really come to the gigs and sit around and watch, I suppose.
Doesn't seem to be a generation gap there at all.
They're not here at the moment, so we can say whatever we want about them.
Be nice, though. We have another email. If we can take a look at that right now, and I can't see it. Okay, here it is. I don't know if you can see this. It says, hey guys, first of all, I love the new stuff. Glad to see the creativity coming out in the music. And I think they go on, and I think they want to just get to the point, and they ask, do you guys like to read? Do you have time to read, maybe?
Sometimes, kind of pass the time a bit. I've read books like, I read Hammer of the Gods a little while ago, and I read a Jack the Ripper book not long ago. It's all right.
And you're not a big reader?
No, I gotta sleep.
Because there must be time to read, I guess, in the stuff on the plane. What do you do on the plane? You just sleep on the plane as well?
Yeah.
That's it. No, you got to pick up those traveling Scrabble games.
In business class, we've got these little televisions.
So you watch them. What kind of channels can you get in the airplane? Way up there, cable.
Videos.
Yeah. Oh, okay.
They pretty much suck, but it kind of wastes a bit of time.
Okay. And Ben, are you?
I hate reading. It sucks. So boring.
I think there was another part to that email. I think there was another part to that email. No? Okay. There. You know what? We do have the email standing by. You know what? You guys have something like 12 websites going on?
We've got a lot.
I know one official Silverchair website, but there's like a whole bunch of fans that come out and...
There's one that a guy called Pete Walton does. That's kind of the one we send a lot of stuff to him ourselves and keep him up to date. And there's another one that the record company actually does.
There's this one called Watson's the Cool One. Watson's our manager. He's our legend. He's so cool.
Okay, you know what? There's still a whole lot more talking from Silverchair coming up real soon. And you know what? You probably want to hear some more playing, right? Yeah, I agree. And it's more playing. All that stuff is coming up and a whole bunch more, so please hang in there. Don't go away. Silverchair right after this break. To play, and these people want to hear them real bad, right? How bad do you want to hear Silverchair play? Coming up as a favorite of a lot of people, we have Israel's Son coming up, and in a few short moments, we're going to take a look and listen to Suicidal Dream. And I think, and if I can, Daniel, I think we need to talk about a couple of these songs, because both were misinterpreted. I know the sort of both were considered almost controversial. And I know that whenever you write, you have to relate to whatever you're writing about. It's very important for you. So how does something like Suicidal Dream relate to you?
The song is about teenage suicide. And it was just, I saw it on telly and it was concerning. And it was a good thing to kind of get off my chest. So I wrote a song about it. It's not meant to be controversial, but, you know.
Is there a particular maybe meaning? Is there maybe a meaning that you're trying to convey in that song at all?
It's up to whoever listens to it. They can kind of make their own meaning out of it.
Okay.
It's just a song. It's just words that I was thinking about.
Okay. Well, that's coming up, and some other stuff. So, once again, Silverchair! Controversial one. About my death, I'll kill myself.
This song is also off our new album. This is called No Association. You may already know this song from a bootleg.
Blood right out of me!
Listen to us talk.
back with Mush and Silverchair are here. They're intimate and they're interactive. You know, we got one more song coming up, and it is Israel's Son. And somehow I knew that was going to be the response. And you know, I have to ask Daniel, because Daniel is the chief songwriter in the band. It is one of those songs, again, that were considered kind of controversial, whether you wish that to happen or not. Look, I'm getting closer. I'm right behind you now. Boo! We have to talk about Israel's Son. I understand you watch a lot of TV. This is another song that was based on something you watched. It was a documentary on the horrors of the Holocaust. Is that true?
Can I speak into your mic, please? It's about just a dream I had, and then I was just seeing all this stuff on telly, and it was similar to my dream, so I wrote a song and, you know, just put some personal stuff in it, like all the songs, and that was it.
And these people are dying to hear it, and you know what? Ready to go? But first, we want to see how Kathleen is doing outside. We got to see how Kathleen's doing outside. People have been out there all night. They're getting rained on. Kathleen,
well,
where are you?
Before we say goodnight, Phil, from out here, the general consensus is, from the street, we want more music.
Well done. Thanks for hanging in with us out there. I know you're very wet, but you know what? You ready? Are you ready? Come on, make some noise. I can't hear you, because you know why? Silverchair!
Instead, yeah, over the middle,
This has been a Much Music production.